I know what you're thinking. Is that guy really jolly, or is he just faking it? Truth of the matter is, I'm always jolly, ha ha! But I'm not that jolly about the Christmas gift I got. Stay tuned. Today, we are taking a look at the Fat Shark Transformer Box Goggles. This is the FSV 1105. And man, we got a lot to talk about this thing. So normally, you think goggles, right? What's the best goggles in the world? Supposedly it's Fat Shark, right? That's what I thought. Now, the one thing that is a real big gotcha on this thing that I didn't know because I read the advertising, and the advertising lied to me. Fake news, fake news. I don't know why the wind's starting to kick up all of a sudden. Maybe the wind's mad too. I don't know, it could be. Let's get down to brass tacks because I don't have the silver ones. So you'll have to live with these. In the advertising, which I'll put up on the screen, obviously you people can't read that, or can you? Maybe you can. In the advertising on several websites, and I will not name those websites, but I will show you the descriptions they have. It explicitly says, which all comes from Fat Shark. It explicitly says, this is a diversity receiver. Until you read down in the fine print and it means, I meant antenna diversity receiver. What's the difference? A lot. So for those that don't understand the difference, it's actually pretty easy. I mean, I understood it. So I think you will, because generally you people are pretty smart out there. A true diversity system has two receivers, one for each antenna. And in the whole workings of the inner brain of this thing, it says, hey, what's a better signal? What's a better signal? What's a better signal? It keeps on going back and forth. It's confusing. It's kind of like being, I don't know, drunk on a Friday night, and you're like, who's hotter? Who's hotter? Who's hotter? You know, you can't tell at 2 o'clock in the morning when you're wasted. Ha! Not that I would know anything about that, because that's never happened to me. In an antenna diversity, there is one receiver, and that receiver does about the same thing. Which antenna is better? Which antenna is better? Which antenna is better? Why is that bad? Because you're not getting an accurate analyzation of the signal from a single receiver versus a dual receiver. And as you saw with the descriptions off of several websites, it is a tad bit misleading. I bought these for two purposes. One, I will be attempting to upgrade the SJ-VO1s, this wacky set of goggles I've been using forever that I still love to death, with a Fury's FPV True 3D module. Some Fat Shark module. No, it's made by Fury FPV. There's a picture of it. There you go. Anyway, I have seen other people do it. I've always meant to do it, but if I put these goggles down, I wouldn't have a set of goggles to fly. You know, let's say I mess up and somehow, you know, I put the wrong wire on the wrong wire and there's a magic genie before me saying, hi, you don't get any wishes because you're an idiot. As a backup plan, I saw somebody out at one of the meets maybe a couple weeks back that had a set of these. And I said, oh, that looks nice. Like, do you mind if I look at him? And he let me fly with him. I said, oh, that's pretty good. And he never mentioned anything about whether this was true diversity or not. Maybe he didn't know. But I said, you know what? That's a good backup. And for about $180 on any one of the given websites, you know, that wasn't too bad of a deal. I said, okay, I'll get them because they also serve a second purpose. The second purpose of these is that I want to start using them in the simulator. So they have the HDMI in for that, which would be very, very lovely. And I thought, okay, that solves that problem. And then I thought and looked around and started reading up on these after, like an idiot, Santa delivered them to me, because Santa goes, hey, here you go, you idiot. I go, oh, Santa, new goggles. And he goes, yeah, you idiot, they're great. I go, oh, thank you, Santa. Stop calling me an idiot. He goes, well, you're the one who asked for them. I go, okay, and after he left, then I knew what he meant. So after viewing these, I thought, okay, they're clear, they're good, we'll fly them around, I'll try and get a camera in here because I got the binocular view, because I thought, why not? You know? Binoculars. I like binoculars. I can see a lot of things with binoculars. Back to what I was discussing earlier I also found out that if I wanted to, I could actually put a Furious FPV module in this. Why would I want to do that? Because I want that diversity. And I believe I can find a good way to hook that in so that I will never use these antennas again. I'll always use the true the Furious FPV modules. 3.5 is what I ordered, the 3.5 module. And put it in here and good as gold. Aside from that, I will try and get a camera in here. With binocular view, generally you're looking at 2, 4, 3 pictures, one on that eye, one on that eye. So you can't really get a camera in here. And I guess I'll try, but we'll try and get a camera and we'll fly around, we'll see how the screen looks. Second thing I did like about these focus great. I have one bad eye for reading. This eye's a little weak, but not that bad. So as far as the other goggles, the SJ-VO1s, I had no way to focus those. And when I got these, I tested them out and I gave them to QFPV and he tested them out. And we found out that for me, I can focus these very well. They're really nicely focused. They have the moving eye parts here in case you need to, you know, in case your eyes are too far apart or something, and then now nobody will ever do a portrait of you. You'll look like a Picasso because your eyes are all the way over here. But some main people have their eyes right there, and then other people have their eyes right there. That's a scientific fact. You're a Picasso. Live with it. And by that I mean you're a Picasso painting where the eyes are just too far apart for anything. You put a third eye in there and it's just like, wow, right? Also, I have to mention, one of the other reasons I do need to mod this anyway is because, guess what? No DVR. What? I know, right? What? Okay. No DVR. Who does not put a DVR in anything these days? Who? Who? This is the new upgraded version, the FBS 1105 was supposed to be some great creation that they did something to. So, you know, there's that. Another thing that makes you wonder, hey Fat Shark, were you people having a Christmas party and you're all drunk on eggnog and rum when you put these together? Because you can't scan. There's no scanning. There's no channel scanning. How these SJ-VO1s, they have a scanner. I can scan everything. I could scan to the planet Mars if I want to. That's why I got the antennas on there. This is true diversity. This is not true diversity. This has a 5808 board in there, some clone of that in it. This has what Fat Shark termed as, you know, all these extra spare parts that they had lying around somewhere and they threw them all in here. Have a holly jolly Christmas, and in case you didn't hear, blah, 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 and we'll have all sorts of cheer. That was your cut rate intermission for the middle of the video. You're welcome. All right, enough of all this jimmering, yamming, jolly jelly Santa Fat Claus with a dumb hat on. Let's go fly! So, as far as screen resolution, this is shooting in 720p or receiving in 720p. It's a really nice picture. I really do like this. The other thing is this is detachable up here. I'm not gonna take it off now, but this is detachable. So if you wanted to run it on a tripod and you wanna look at the screen, I think you'd see it very well. It's very sharp colors. It almost felt 3D. because the OSD was here and then everything else behind it. I enjoyed it. It was very contrasty. I liked that color, that type of look where the colors are a little bit more saturated and stuff. As far as fit, it is very comfortable on your face. I have absolutely no problem with the foam that's around there, how it sits on your nose, how good or bad the strap is. It's actually a very good strap. And I really feel like, you know, I can deal with this. The view, coming from what I was looking at, I looked at 7-inch before, now I'm looking at 5-inch, really kind of squeezed down to probably about 55 degrees, I think, is the viewing angle on these, where I'm used to seeing about 110. It was a little bit of a distraction, but I didn't mind it. If I had to live with these for a little bit, they'd be fine. They'd be good ride-along goggles for someone who just wants to watch you fly. All in all, not bad for a primary set of goggles. However, I just feel like the advertising for this, or the description of it, is a bit misleading. They're still good goggles. For $189, I don't know if they're that good, but they're still good. Comes with a Fat Shark battery, and if you... Oh, where'd I put the battery? Hang on a second. Comes with a Fat Shark battery. I think this is the... let's see. I know I got my glasses under my chin. Shush. 1000 milliamp. I knew I could do it. I could read it without it. And if you have these ear sheens around, which I had from previous goggles that I never got rid of because I thought one day I'm going to have to use these, this is actually a 1600 milliamp battery. And they both have the same plugs. That is going to wrap it up for this Christmas Eve day. I hope you people have a very, 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 very Merry Christmas. I hope your dinner is good. I hope your nighttime eggnog is good. And I hope you get a tryptophan coma that puts you out for 3 days and you get all the rest you need. Because sometimes we just need rest. So from the beautiful city of Tampa, Florida, on a beautiful Christmas Day Eve, we're all waiting for Santa. I already saw him in the tractor. He's on his way. All the way here to this beautiful city called Tampa, Florida. This is the mighty Thor. See ya!